time it is, your boy DC Young Fly, Mr. Bring That Ass Here, boy. Fuck you, man. West Side all the way down with Link Up TV, man. Get it. Rock, rock.
Bitch, I like the man.
What's happening? It's your boy, Mr. Play, Prince of the UK parties, basically the fucking man. And right now I'm here with the one and only DC Young Fly. What's happening?
Man, you know what time it is, man. Yeah. Crazy. Oh, me trying to explain, listen, know what the hell he's saying, but I'm getting it. Let's do it.
And I'm trying to get what he's saying.
Fuck you, man.
So basically, like in the UK, the youngsters are familiar with you, and my son said, Dad, you need to check out this guy called DC. I'm like, what the fuck you mean?
He UK? Goes,
yeah.
Oh, shit.
So my son, so you got to send a shout out to Terrell.
Terrell, what the hell going on, fool? Fuck you, man. We out here, man. Keep spreading the word, man. Let them folks know what's going on.
So he's like, Dad, you need to check out this guy who's he's been arguing with that boxer and Kevin Hart.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I don't so play no game.
How did that come about? What happened?
I mean, you know, that's just everyday what I do on Instagram is just everyday how we. That's the hood comedy, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My brand, hood comedy, you know. Ain't all about shooting and drug selling and robbing and all that extra stuff. How we have a good time in the hood, it's just like that. Whatever we going through, we trying to get the laughter out of it, you feel what I'm saying? So that's just how I brought about. I just took it to Instagram. I was like, man, whoever want to get it. That's how I brought up. I was getting taken out. Nigga used to kill me, but they know about me. I made a name, man. I went crazy.
So when you first started off, did you foresee yourself going in the direction your career's gone? Because it's like from someone over in the south of America to you becoming a household name.
Man, it was crazy, man. Cause I popped off on Vine, saluted my boy Fanny Pay, but then I switched from Vine to Instagram because I had a little bit more sex just to be a little ignorant. You feel what I'm saying? And I started on Instagram like around February. I started everything November 22nd of last year. You feel what I'm saying?
And you're on, you got a fan base of over a million now. You're touching two.
It ain't even been a year. So I just took it and I ran with it. You feel what I'm saying? So I was like, it was a blessing. And somebody had told me, they said, Steve Harvey said that once you recognize your purpose in life, your blessings start coming from out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's only been from November 22nd, and it ain't even been a year.
Yeah.
I was too busy out there in them streets. And then when I took my concentration off that and then took it over to comedy and entertainment, I ain't never looked back.
So growing up, what area are you from?
I'm from Westside, Atlanta, MLK, Adamville. They know what time it is.
Do you find that people you've grown with have now changed towards you because of your success, or and be honest, be real.
No, not really. I mean, you know, you see fake people every day. The higher I grow, the more fake people come around. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because they know me. They know what's on. They know how I tell them keep it real. What have you done for me? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For real. I don't play no game. Nigga ain't never gave me nothing, so don't be looking for nothing coming out for me. You feel what I'm saying? But it's a difference when you expand your horizon. You feel what I'm saying? Like when I go back to the hood, I see like, dang, it's different, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, from the outside world, you feel what I'm saying? Like, some people be stuck in the hood.
Yeah.
And I see why, and I see how, because I was one. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I just recognized my blessing, and I took it. And then he helped me to expand, you know what I'm saying, to go further. And then it's a different world, but I just go back just trying to tell people, man, just stay down, find what you're going to do, and go hard. And it's 2014. You ain't got to sell dope no more. If you ain't already been selling dope, don't start now. I'm telling you. You're going to fuck your life up.
So, the transition to rap, did you start off as comedy, become a comedian, turn into a rapper, or was you a rapper?
I was doing rap first. I got 3 mixtapes on Live Mixtape.
Oh,
what? Before anything. Yeah. Go on Live Mixtape, type in YUNGFLY, go type in Young Fly, or you can go to YouTube and just type in Young Fly. Type in Young Fly the Crew. You're going to see a couple of our videos. I had a hit song in 2010. And I got over 100,000 views.
Oh, yeah?
That year.
Okay.
You feel what I'm saying? So, I just ain't had nobody behind me. So, I was just a city name. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And plus, I was out here trying to run my money up. So, it was all me. You feel what I'm saying?
So, right now, are you in a record deal?
I ain't interrupted, dude. I got a man in me, Archive. Archive Nation.
Shout out to Archive.
Yeah. The crew. What's happening?
So, do you see yourself as a signed artist, or do you want to do it independent? Because obviously, there's a lot of independent artists that are making wave and don't necessarily.
I mean, I'm independent. I got a management.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Like my whole team is a management, but we go so hard, we look like a label.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, so, we a brand, and before all these big record deals, they was all small before they got big.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Before you know it, between the next 2 to 5 years, our guy gonna be the biggest thing popping, like LaFace.
Remember you where you heard it first, Link Up. Remember?
You know what I'm saying? We gonna be going crazy. We gonna be at the top with the rest of these people. And they got to come see us. They got to.
So what's your 3 to 5 year plan? Because a lot of artists now are becoming entrepreneurs. You know. The record industry is more than just selling music. You gotta be an all rounder. You gotta sell merchandise. What's your plan?
3 to 5, I don't want to get all my people out the hood. All my family members out the hood.
Yeah.
I'm straight. Everything else, I'm whatever after that, it's good. Just trying to raise some young jits to make money. Other than that, I'm good. I done did a lot in life. And I'm blessed to be here sitting with you. You feel what I'm saying? And make people laugh, man. So I'm a blessing, man. So I'm just trying to get my people out the hood.
So, a lot of the UK girls especially are going to want to know, are you single?
Oh, I'm not single. I'm not single, man. I got my baby, man. You know, but, you know.
Let's keep it moving.
I'll tell you. UK!
So, when are you coming to the UK? Is this something we can see happen in the future?
Yes. Call me. Call and ask for me, man.
Yeah.
I'm coming. All you gotta do, call my people, ask for me. I'm coming to UK. I done been to Paris and all that stuff before. So call me. I'm coming to United Kingdom, man. I'm coming.
So he can travel. He's not really looking that can. Yeah, he's got a passport, people.
Yes, I got a passport. And you need to hurry. You hurry up because my expiration, I ain't got too long. 2015 coming up. Only got a little bit. That's how you say it? A little bit. So come on, man.
Well, do you know what? Thank you very much for your time, brother.
All the way from USA, man, to the UK. Fuck right. You, mean, man. We out here. Bring that ass here, boy.
So many inside you like a bed. When I made it home, I'm like a liar. Trying to come up with a plan.